And he requests that he address the audience for a few minutes on whatever you want to say.
Whatever, sir. It's your end.
I'm very happy that there is so much interest in learning new things from the younger generations. I was very happy to see my own son, Dr. Subramanian, presently a good case of hydrocephalus. I was reminded of a similar incident about 50 years ago when you used to have conferences in the afternoon. Dr. Ramamurthy, Dr. Balasubramanian, myself as the neurosurgeon. Dr. Jagannathan Ramchandas as the neurologist. And we used to discuss about hydrocephalus when to operate. The crux of the problem is the quantity of the brain does not reflect the quality of the brain. But I was myself very surprised when I fell down while walking in a temple 2 years ago and had a little fracture of the nose. Being a neurosurgeon, I went and had a CT scan done. I was surprised at the amount of cerebral atrophy age-related I had. And I was happy I was able to function so well. So we had a similar X-ray then. Not the MRI, but a air ventriculogram showing the size of the ventricle. So we used to have a harmless joking in between. Since Dr. Ramamurthy is a neurosurgeon, told Dr. Jagannathan, a neurologist, Charlie has got 1 centimeter cortex, he can become a neurologist. But Jagannathan was back in the 90s said, I agree, sir, it's good enough. But supposing it progresses further and becomes 0.5 centimeter, he can always take up neurosurgery. So the message is, we can only measure the anatomy. Difficult to measure the physiology. And whatever physiology you measure, in such a complex thing as a brain, it is so difficult. And we are still learning every day. So many advances, I learned so many things listening to the previous speakers. I'm so happy to be here and wish you all the best.
Please remain on the stage for a minute. President, sir, I will request Professor Kalyanaraman to tell the audience how he brought in the concept of a CME into India. He was instrumental about it several years ago. So I would request him to talk about that.
See, 1973, I went on a world tour with his mother. And one of the conferences we attended was the Honolulu, the Congress of Neurological Surgeons. And I was impressed with the amount of CMA they did. There are no papers, no statistics, nothing. It's all series of lectures, just as you are having now. And they came back and told the Neurological Society of India, Executive Committee meeting, I was a member, that we should have a similar program in the NSI, So next year, persisted. Next year also I became the editor and persistent. Finally, they could not tolerate my nuisance. They said, all right, you organize it. And made me the organizer for the CME program. 1979, I remember in Pune, 1977, we had a CME. It was so popular that the audience refused to go for the inaugural function by the minister. We had to cut short the program and say, look, the minister is waiting. You better go into the hall and have the inauguration. That caught on like wildfire. I'm very happy that by God's grace, I was the person to start the CME in Neurological Institute of India, one of the very first things to do. And now, all over the country, there's so much of CME, so much of learning, and so much of new things coming on. Things like hands-on workshop, things like practical things. I'm so happy about it. Every time I attend a CME, I feel very good things happening and knowledge is increasing and ultimately the patients are benefiting. That is a great thing. I am thankful for it. Thank you.